to the only wise God, through Jesus Christ, be glory forever and ever. Tonight we focus on worship. As part of our Advent waiting, we worship. And we will sing together now, O Come, Emmanuel. We're singing verses 1 and 5. Stir up your power, Lord Christ, and come. May we with Mary sing your praises and magnify your name. As we worship, renew our vision that we may do your will. In your name we pray. Amen. We read our psalm. Praise the Lord. Praise the Lord, O my soul. I will praise the Lord as long as I live. I will sing praises to my God all my life long. Do not put your trust in princes, in mortals, in whom there is no help. When their breath departs, they return to the earth. On that very day, their plans perish. Happy are those whose help is the God of Jacob, whose hope is in the Lord their God, who made heaven and earth, the sea and all that is in them, who keeps faith forevermore, who executes justice for the oppressed, who gives food to the hungry. The Lord sets the prisoners free. The Lord opens the eyes of the blind. The Lord lifts up those who are bowed down. The Lord loves the righteous. The Lord watches over the strangers. He upholds the orphan and the widow. But the way of the wicked he brings to ruin. The Lord will reign forever. Your God, O Zion, for all generations. Praise the Lord. Blessed indeed are they who put their trust in you, O God, our sure rock and refuge. Guard us from giving to any other the allegiance that belongs only to you. Shine upon us with the brightness of your light, that we may love you with a pure heart and praise you forever. Through Jesus Christ, our Savior and Lord. Amen. Tonight, we read the visit of the angel Gabriel to Mary, and we read that passage from Luke chapter 1, verses 26 through 55. In the sixth month, the angel Gabriel was sent by God to a town in Galilee called Nazareth, to a virgin engaged to a man whose name was Joseph, of the house of David. The virgin's name was Mary. And Gabriel came to her and said, "Greetings, favored one, the Lord is with you." She was much perplexed by his words and pondered what sort of greeting this might be. The angel said to her, "Do not be afraid, Mary, for you have found favor with God. And now you will conceive in your womb and bear a son, and you will name him Jesus. He will be great and will be called the Son of the Most High. And the Lord God will give to him the throne of his ancestor David. He will reign over the house of Jacob forever, and of his kingdom there will be no end." Mary said to the angel, "How can this be, since I am a virgin?" The angel said to her, "The Holy Spirit will come upon you, and the power of the Most High will overshadow you. Therefore, the child to be born will be holy. He will be called Son of God. And now, your relative Elizabeth, in her old age, has also conceived a son, and this is the sixth month for her who was said to be barren. For nothing will be impossible with God." And then Mary said, "Here am I, the servant of the Lord. Let it be with me according to your word." And then the angel departed from her. There is more. So in those days, Mary set out and went with haste to a Judean town in the hill country, where she entered the house of Zechariah and greeted Elizabeth. And when Elizabeth heard Mary's greeting, the child leaped in her womb, and Elizabeth was filled with the Holy Spirit and exclaimed with a loud cry, "Blessed are you among women, and blessed is the fruit of your womb. And why has this happened to me that the mother of my Lord comes to me? For as soon as I heard the sound of your greeting, the child in my womb leaped for joy. And blessed is she who believed that there would be a fulfillment of what was spoken to her by the Lord." Mary then sang, "My soul magnifies the Lord, and my spirit rejoices in God my Savior, for he has looked with favor on the lowliness of his servant. Surely, from now on, all generations will call me blessed, for the Mighty One has done great things for me, and holy is his name. His mercy is for those who fear him from generation to generation. He has shown strength with his arm. He has scattered the proud in the thoughts of their hearts. He has brought down the powerful from their thrones and lifted up the lowly. He has filled the hungry with good things and sent the rich away empty. He has helped his servant Israel in remembrance of his mercy, according to the promise he made to our ancestors, to Abraham, and to his descendants forever. So before it fades away too fast, what image or phrase or word continues to ring in your ears? What vision, as I read, was in your mind that you're still holding on to? I'm going to remind you of a couple things. The angel said to Mary, "Do not be afraid, for you have found favor with God." This day, right now, where might you leave fear behind? Do not fear, for you have found favor with God. What fear can you leave behind? Now, this passage was full of worship. So how does worship of God give you clarity of vision, particularly the vision of what God might desire for you and God's purposes? How does worship give you clarity? How will you magnify the Lord today or through the next few days? How will you express worship and praise? And where in you or in those around you has God lifted up the lowly, filled the hungry, and helped with mercy? I sent out the digital bulletin to all of you and that are connected to us email-wise. And if you're a person that tunes in and you don't get that, our email is stpaulashville@gmail.com, and no, not com, gmail.com, yes. That's all one word, stpaulashville@gmail.com. Email us there, and I'll make sure that you can share in on these worship resources. So, but go back to those if you need to, after you're done with the video, and think about those, because they were all just really deep questions. I am going to then take us to a song, a carol, and that is "What Child Is This?" And that's number 40 in the LBW, if you happen to have that at home. And otherwise, it's printed in that bulletin, "What Child Is This?" And I was running late. My fingers need to play it through at least once for us. Let us pray. The Spirit and the Church cry out, Amen. Come, Lord Jesus. All those who watch for Christ's coming pray, Amen. Come, Lord Jesus. The whole creation pleads, Amen. Come, Lord Jesus. In this time, we look with eagerness for the breaking in of the light into the darkness. We thank you, God, that you have had an eye on us since the time of creation. You promised to Abraham and his ancestors. And today we speak ancient words of now there is a Savior. Now the Son of God is among us. Word made flesh. Coming to save. Being the Redeemer for us all. We thank you for the joy of this time when we remember that you are a God who comes down. Your love comes down. We are especially grateful for that promise in the midst of just rising numbers of those with COVID again, pandemic raging, pandemic causing chaos in lives and jobs and health, a time when those who are in helping professions are just so tired. I ask that you would strengthen them. Be with all those who are caring for family members who are sick. Bring healing mightily to those who are failing. We know in your wisdom that for some, that final healing will be what brings them peace. The healing of life into death and in your arms and in your hands. We ask that you be with those who are dying this day. And we ask that you give strength and courage to those who will continue to live life in this place and time. I ask that you be with families that are coming together. Guard those who are traveling. That you help those who are feeling resentments and hatreds to find love. Help those who cannot forgive to find forgiveness. To help those who are angry find softened hearts. Pray that those who are hungry and cold, that they be comforted with food and shelter. Use us as we will be those who bring those gifts. Guide us waking, O Lord, and guard us sleeping, that awake we may watch with Christ, and asleep we may rest in peace. Amen. We're gathered together by the Spirit, and so we pray the prayer our Lord Jesus taught us. Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread. And forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. For thine is the kingdom, and the power, and the glory, forever and ever. Amen. So now, as we draw near to the birth of the Christ child, let us remember that even as we wait, and even as we watch, and even as we wonder, and even as we worship, God is with us. So go in peace this evening. May Christ go with you.